Hey everybody, I'm just going to do a quick sound check. Oh yeah, cool. Everyone hear that? Cool. I'm also running this off a web browser, so yeah, and it's my code, so I'll leave it at that. Just quickly about myself. I'm at the State Library. I've got an industrial design background. And I've released music many, many moons ago as a solo artist and also with a band called The Herd. UI as a function of state. I'm pretty sure most people would know this concept. You have some state, you have a function, and it spits out some UI. Sometimes that UI is made up of other functions. I thought, okay, that's cool. Maybe we can have the same sort of concept to spit out music, to render music. So I looked into creating a library called Reactronica. And I've got a website. It's very, very early days. It's my first library. Inspired by another project called React Music, which some people might have used before. And it's all browser-based, uses ToneJS underneath. I'll quickly go through some code samples. So we import a song component from Reactronica, and then have a few props. It's not playing right now. We have BPM. Also import a track component, and we have some steps. So these steps are just three notes, A, E, and C. The three is the octave, third octave on a piano, and the null is a rest. So we also assign a synthesizer. Oh, some audio, it's playing now. Let's bring down the tempo a little bit. It's more my sort of style of tempo. We can also have chords. So if you wrap the individual notes in arrays, you can have chords, play multiple notes at a time. Change the sound as well, different type of synthesizer. We can also add effects as well. So this is just a reverb. I'm just going to make the chords a little bit more interesting. All right, let's add another track. We've got a sampler. So a sampler is a different type of instrument. It's a one-shot instrument, and it just references files off your hard drive, off your website. So I've got a kick. Let's bring the kick in. So kick's pretty cool, but let's get a snare in there as well. And then I'll get like a little hi-hat as well. Okay. And I like bass, so let's get some bass. Alright, so we got a little beat going on. So that's cool. You're just rendering. Thank you. So you're just rendering audio. You're not seeing anything. Let's get some UI into there because most people are probably working on UI. So let's make some space and we'll move all our steps into some state, assign the state to our track. And here's a piano roll step sequencer thing I created earlier. And it doesn't have any steps in there, so I assign the steps into this. It's sort of not too complicated, but yeah, I've got the code up in open source if you want to check it out. And let's play it. This is just the piano right now, the synthesizer. So it'd be good if we could get feedback on where you're at, the playhead. So I've got a current step. I'll get a callback. So the track component has a callback called on step play, and then I can get some feedback. So that's working with UI. So you notice that the UI and the Reactronica components are all together. The state is all in the one place. Update the state, UI, and audio changes. Okay? Here's another kind of UI, ukulele tablature. Is anyone familiar with guitar tablature? Yep, a few people. These are the notes of the strings, and the zero and the three, they're the frets. So zero is an open fret. You can also update this in real time. Here's a sheet music component. This is actually a song from the State Library. We've got a whole bunch of sheet music from the 1800s. So we are sort of cool. And finally, yeah, just been working on a digital audio workstation, similar to Logic, Ableton, Cubase, if anyone's ever had experience of those things. So this is all in the browser as well. And let's hope this all works, okay? So. I'll bring the beat in. Yeah, there's a few links there on the Reactronica website to that kind of door application. It's totally a lot of smoke and mirrors, all right, but still working on it. GitHub, love to get lots of feedback. My slides are online as well. And yeah, they were made with React Spectacle and React Live. And thank you very much. Thanks.